2020 Mentor Channel.
Hi, and welcome to this short briefing. We are going to speak about the Airbus training recommendations on overspeed prevention and recovery techniques. The aim of this video is to explain why Airbus has published a training recommendation about overspeed prevention and recovery techniques. We also want to provide you, as an instructor, with information about what is proposed to be trained and how you can conduct this training in full flight simulator. As for the other training recommendation published by Airbus, the training recommendation on overspeed prevention and recovery techniques is in the Airbus Flight Crew Training Standards manuals. The FCTS manuals are available on Airbus World website. Let's start with the reason why Airbus has decided to publish a training recommendation about overspeed prevention and recovery techniques. Regularly, overspeed occurrences are reported by operators to Airbus. Some of these overspeed events have led to inappropriate pilot reactions. These reactions that may be induced by a startle effect can be, for example, an instinctive disconnection of the autopilot followed by an important backward movement on the side stick. A disconnection of the autothrust due to a rapid movement of the thrust levers to idle without thrust adjustments once out of overspeed situation. The analysis of these overspeed events has permitted to identify some training items that may improve the management of overspeed situations. These training items are detailed in the training recommendation on overspeed prevention and recovery techniques. These training recommendations also give the training condition to simulate realistic overspeed events. Let's now see what are the training items contained in the overspeed training recommendation. The first training items focus on the reinforcement of knowledge. One training objective is to review the conditions prone to the occurrence of overspeed. As an example, a late initiation of the descent beyond the computed top of descent reduces the margin versus an overspeed situation. The aircraft speed is at the upper limit of the descent speed range. The autothrust is already in idle mode. Another training objective is to highlight the recommendation to keep the autopilot and the autothrust engaged in the case of an overspeed situation. The reinforcement of pilot's awareness on startle effect is also an objective of the overspeed training recommendation. The Airbus Wind video, The Two Sides of Fear, is a useful support for this objective. The role of the pilot monitoring has also to be highlighted. The PM can bring efficient support to the pilot flying by announcing the detected deviations and by applying effective intervention strategies to resolve any identified deviations. Once the different knowledge have been reviewed and reinforced, the training recommendation proposes some exercises to be done in full flight simulator. The first objective of the exercises in the simulator is to reinforce the pilot's confidence about the autopilot and autothrust response in an overspeed situation. Of course, the application of the overspeed prevention and recovery techniques is also a training objective. To reinforce handling skills, it is recommended to practice overspeed and recovery techniques with automations, but also without autopilot nor autothrust. Let's now see how to conduct this training in a full flight simulator. To reach the training objective, two overspeed scenarios are detailed in the training recommendation. It is important to highlight here that these two overspeed scenarios are based on the use of a UPRT function. This UPRT function, used for the simulation of overspeed events, is called airspeed increase or longitudinal wind shear. Airbus has sent a dedicated communication to the training devices manufacturers to encourage them to verify that this UPRT function is activated on the instructor operating station with the correct tuning of the wind model. In the absence of this UPRT function on the instructor operating station, it is recommended not to practice overspeed training in the full flight simulator. The first overspeed scenario permits to obtain variations of the indicated airspeed close to, but below the VMO MMO without triggering the overspeed warning. The objective of this scenario is to create training conditions leading to the application of the overspeed prevention technique. The second scenario permits to obtain speed excursions above VMO MMO with the activation of the overspeed warning, but without entering into the high speed protection. The objective of this overspeed event is to create training conditions leading to the application of the overspeed recovery technique. These two scenarios allow to create realistic overspeed situations. In order to reach the training objectives and to avoid any negative learning, it is recommended to trigger these scenarios in the conditions detailed in the training recommendation. To expose the flight crew to surprise effect, it is also recommended to trigger an overspeed event while the crew attention is oriented to a specific task, such as descent preparation or management of an ICAM alert. This training item for surprise and startle effect can be conducted in the same simulator session than the other training items detailed in the overspeed training recommendations, or it can be done in another training session. To conclude, I would like to recall that the training recommendation about overspeed prevention and recovery techniques is based on the analysis of several overspeed events reported to Airbus. The training items detailed in these training recommendations have been identified as countermeasures for the management of threats and errors associated with the overspeed events. This training recommendation should give you, as an instructor, the opportunity to develop trainees' competencies needed for the management of overspeed events. I hope you enjoy this video, and I will see you around for the next one.
A320 Mentor Channel. Thanks for watching.